All right. It's all coming down to a game seven. Home team has won every game so far. I've got to pull one out in San Francisco. Damn you, Cueto. Damn you, Samardzija. This game went 19 innings. Rattled off three straight at Wrigley. Made Etemor a starting pitcher in July when Hamill was struggling. Hamill's been a great, great long man. Even if he did take the loss last night in 15 innings, naturally. All right, I can't put this off anymore. Same lineup I used to fuck up Bumgarner in game four, so here's hoping. And it's Seattle in six games, waiting for the winner to arrive. They have like two good position players. They have Nelson Cruz and Cano and Seager, I guess.
I'm told that the last remaining seats for this one were snapped up within 11 minutes of going on sale. National League Championship Series between the Chicago Cubs and the San Francisco Giants. Hi again, everyone. Matt Vasgersian. Welcome to our special postseason coverage of Baseball on the Show. With me are Eric Karros and Steve Lyons. And Steve, everything to play for here as we get ready for Game 7.
Yeah, and I think there's a lot of pressure here in the building tonight. I mean, you can feel it when you just walk into this place. The players know what's at stake. The fans know what's at stake. The winner goes to the World Series. The loser goes home. The stakes don't come any bigger than this.
Set for what should be a good one. Lineups and first pitch are next.
I've played every playoff game. I played well over 50% of the regular season games. So I'm really not ready for this to end.
And now your 2016 San Francisco Giants.
But I'm not gonna let it. Make sure I got the right lineup in here.
And briefly here, a glance at the two starters who'll get the ball here in this one.
Those numbers, though, not great for anyone.
With that, a look at the Cubbies' starting lineup. Who do you have your eye on, EK?
Yeah, you know, you have to be careful with Daddy Longlegs and
my lineup
Dexter
is
Fowler.
Let's
does a lot
see
of things
how
right
the
at
Giants
the plate.
Have it.
Takes the simple approach and depends to pay off.
And with that, let's take a look at the Giants
Blanco
lineup defensively. It's brought to us by Majestic. Any thoughts, Eric?
Well, guys, we've got a gold glover behind the plate. How that helps the ball club, you can throw balls in the dirt as a pitcher, cuts down the running game, really impacts the game defensively.
Dexter Fowler heads for the batter's box, and we are just about ready for some evening baseball.
All right. Span's got a good arm and he's fast. Might bunt on me later. Blanco, I'm not worried about. And Pence, I don't even want to talk about. I hate that guy. Wind blowing out to left. 6 miles an hour. Dexter, by the way, is only 99 contact against lefties, so not a bad guy to get things started.
pitch taken for ball one as we get underway here at 7:06.
I'm sure he's going to get that call later.
First pitch, 7:06.
This one's a strike. It's 1-1. Game time temperature here an even 60 degrees.
Sounds like San Francisco.
Grounded down the third baseline, but a foul ball, 1-2 now.
A little bit too jumpy on that one.
And that misses 2-2. Here's a ball lined over the head of Crawford into left center of base hit.
It's definitely a good start when you're facing a guy like this in his home park. You've got to find a way to put some pressure on him. Don't want him to get settled out there.
Shane Victorino will stand in, and this pitching staff has kept his bat solid. I don't want to do
anything, but I knocked around Bumgarner for six runs in 2 minutes. Two plus innings. He did survive the second. Got his at bat.
Bumgarner sets. Here's the first pitch. Ball strike to the 35-year-old veteran. Nothing in one.
Here, you've got good speed on base and at the plate. So, on a ground ball, it's not a foregone conclusion. You're going to get out anyway.
Nobody out. Runner
still haven't figured that one out, but I'm almost thinking about bunting here, but I'm going to let him work. Let's see.
He almost gave him a three base. So let's take a peek at the umpiring crew in this one. Behind the plate is Ricky Holiday.
Well, kind of strangely, Holiday has a bit of a reputation for rewarding the high strike. You know, and that can really upset the hitter sometimes because the pitcher isn't usually trying to throw it there. So let's see if any of that shows up.
That will work as the bunt. Perfect. Bumped on the changeup.
Yeah, it looks like these guys need business. Back-to-back singles here to start the ball game.
His changeup is too good for his own good.
They want to put as much pressure on this guy as they can early on.
Chris Bryant will stand in an early RBI opportunity here in Game 7.
And it goes without saying, this is an important one to cash in on. You don't know how many more opportunities you're going to get, so you've got to make everyone count.
Is he gonna come slider again?
First pitch of the at bat. And he lays off there, 1-0.
I think that's consistent with how the strike zone gets called nowadays. That's a
maybe
strike
that inside
in the
corner won't be there tonight.
Most umpires won't give you that pitch anymore.
Mr. Ricky Holiday.
Count here it is. This is skied into short left center. Crawford onto the grass.
He went back to the slider, all right.
One out.
Well, anytime you get an RBI guy to the plate with less than two outs, he does that. He is not Zobrist. That's the kind of at bat that'll stick with you for a while.
Ben Zobrist will get his first opportunity here in Game 7, and obviously a lot riding on every at-bat at this point.
Yeah, it's win or go home, and this is where you really have to start to lean on your stars. So he's going to have a lot of pressure on his shoulders to come up with something big.
No double plays tonight. No time for that shit. Ain't got time.
That was asking for one.
That's the pitch he needs to get working here in this first inning. He can solve a few problems here if that pitch comes around.
oddly correct, Eric Harris.
Good hard slider there, but it runs away. It's a ball and a strike.
Yeah, and when that pitch starts off outside, it's much easier to get a better view of it and then just lay off.
Runners are at first and second with one away. Gets on top of one here and chops it foul right at home plate. Here he comes on a ball and two strikes. So two balls and two strikes
oh,
now.
Man.
You have to ask yourself, was he trying to throw a fastball for a strike right there?
Or was
he just
mad.
Trying to set me up for that changeup away?
First and second now, one man out. Chop foul at the plate, and the count holds it 2-2.
Damn,
to the
left. Ball.
Goes to third with it.
Oh,
you sneaky. One's all they were ever going to get, and the inning will continue.
Try,
no real harm in this defensively.
Javier.
Instead of trying for two up the middle, he says, hey, why don't I just flip this thing over to third and get that lead runner? You know, it's a little bit unconventional, but gets you a step closer to getting out of the inning.
Only Matt Bum in Game 7 could do that. I've played over 100 games, and I haven't heard that line because no opposing pitcher would be able to just chop it in almost at that double play. Javi, oh, it's going
to
hold up.
And the two-out threat will not come to pass as the inning is over. Cubs
you
strand a couple.
Are a wizard,
and now we'll
Mad
see
Bum.
What the Giants can do. No score. And with that, a look at Bruce Bochy's lineup card for the Giants. Steve, how do they go about keeping the series alive?
Well, I think they have to understand where they're
Let's
playing.
See.
It's a great pitcher's ballpark, so you're not going to go out there trying to hit the life towers if everything is swinging. Make solid contact, move the line, and play a little bit more small ball.
And there you see Denard Span
all right,
as he
Span.
Gets ready to lead off the
home. Couldn't try and drop down a bunt any time.
Center fielder.
Unfortunately.
And now the third baseman sneaks in.
Except now he probably won't. So I have him in for no reason, but it's Schrodinger's bunt, you know. We'll bunt until I bring Brian down.
Sinker to open the AB in there for strike one.
Yeah, we're going to need that sinker. I did beef up Hendricks a little bit. I didn't get him into the 90s, though. Because he just, you know, led the National League in ERA this year is all.
And he
it helps if guys chase
two.
When I miss by 2 feet with my sinker. He's anxious.
A wind up and the 0-2 pitch. Swung
oh,
on
it's game seven.
He
he's nervous.
The
he doesn't know
and
what he
makes
wants.
The throw to first. Span is retired, and there's one away.
That is a nice job behind the
right
plate.
Fielder.
He wants it
Hunter.
Low, so he's got a good idea that this ball might be in the dirt, so he's able to smother it and then make the strong throw to first.
This guy, I would love to be able to throw a beanball at him right now.
Here's the right fielder, Hunter Pence.
Nope.
He'll start him right. Here with a changeup, but it's taken
close
for
my
one.
Because it's actually like under 50 degrees.
Bases are empty, one man.
Finally. Oh. What do you want, Hunter?
Ready with the 1-0 pitch. That one's a called strike. Back even at one. Sinker misses that time, and it's 2-1. Now, people describe this guy as throwing a heavy sinker.
Yeah,
do you guys agree
do.
With that assessment?
Everybody
yeah, I think
a
so. I mean,
in this game
it's hard to
a
explain
sinker.
Why that's the case, but it's true. When you run into a guy with a good sinker and lots of movement on it, it just feels like you're hitting a bowling ball. The ball just doesn't go anywhere.
And another foul ball.
Die, Hunter.
One out, nobody on. Strike three on a pitch in the dirt. And the throw is made to record the second out of the inning.
Batting third.
And with two gone now, let's take a look at our up-to-the-minute playoff three. And our winner here will take on the AL champion Seattle Mariners. And congratulations to them on their ALCS victory.
The AL champion, Seattle.
Buster Posey gets his first cuts now. The bases are empty, and there are two away here in the opening frame.
All right, let's keep shutting him down.
He kind of needs to put up a tough at-bat right here just to make this guy work a little bit.
It swung on and hit in the air. On the move is Fowler. He gets there to make the catch, and that ends the inning. An inning in the books tonight, still scoreless here on the show. Anthony Rizzo makes his way to the plate. He'll get us started here in the top of the second.
And this is a guy that can make a big change in this game. One swing of the bat, because you know he has big-time power.
And that swung on and missed for strike one.
That's a good way to start a hitter.
Changeup. That's a good pitch there to start this AB.
That's over, but low, it's a ball and a strike. Line toward right center.
Yeah, shift on that.
Base hit here, his first of the night.
Batting seven, shortstop, Addison Russell.
It's funny, I feel like batting average
settling in
doesn't
now.
Matter
Addison
all that
Russell.
Much anymore until the playoffs. He'll get to take his first cuts like here. A great indicator. You know what this guy's been up to. On base, obviously. Slugging, obviously, but
this is hit high in the air out toward left center. Span is
that's
under
not gonna
it.
Help any of them.
Makes the play, one away.
And it's up to Wilson if they want to pitch to him.
Batting eight. Catcher. Wilson Contreras.
Wilson Contreras is in to take his first swings here with the runner still
that's
at first and one away.
Well, too bad that last guy
biggest
couldn't
problem
advance
with not having
position,
home field
so
is not the last
at bat,
but
to
it's not
home.
Getting my walk-up music.
A little
see? That's what happens.
In time to first, and there are two away.
No, it's up to
yeah, the only silver lining to
somehow
this
lost
offensively is that
batting
you get that guy up to
veteran.
Second base, and now
Kyle
he's in scoring position
Hendricks.
With two outs. But I would
that
doubt
pitcher.
Seriously that that was his intention.
All right, Kyle.
Coming to the plate now, Kyle
here's
Hendricks.
It.
And he could give his guys an early lead if he can come through here.
Oh, and it's let's so it. Important to take advantage of these kind of opportunities early in a ball game. It can change the entire complexion of the game if you can put the other guys on their heels right
oh,
away.
That's too high.
Too high, 1-0. Not close. It's 2-0.
Well,
he's just
going to
go right on taking pitches. You have to throw strikes here with two outs, especially when you got the pitcher up.
It's a good question. If I want to take here. There's a good chance it's going to throw a cookie. I'm looking for a cookie.
Grounded to third. Duffy is there.
I opted not to go for the tag.
One left for the Cubs. We'll go to the bottom of the second. No score.
No regrets. He might have a few, but I don't.
Brandon Belt will get his shot now. Great power numbers during the regular season. Still searching for that first home run in the postseason.
I wish they would show me his regular season numbers occasionally. I don't see them at all now that I'm in the second round of the playoffs.
Pretty well neutralized him all October long.
Heck, I don't think there's any way I could see them if I tried in any of the menus or anything. And he seems to like the ball down, so Super Baller will have to deal with that.
Strike to start the at bat, nothing in one.
Yeah, the best way to neutralize this guy's power, just keep putting pitches right there.
As I said, in fewer words.
Swing and he pops him up over toward foul territory.
That's how
you
neutralize the power.
And he's retired here, one away.
That'll be a frustrating at bat.
The shortstop.
But he's got to be thinking Brandon. He let one get away there.
Robert.
That's a pitch he should have been able to handle.
Speaking of painting, changing speeds is good too.
Here's the shortstop, Brandon Crawford.
That's the song that kind of sounds like the news.
Started to go around, but it's ruled strike one anyway.
There's all these songs in this game that are like generic genre. Generic genre songs. Generic songs. But they're common sounding. We're doing a nice job.
We
got a nice little jazz quartet little coming at Wrigley. And the organ at Wrigley sounds great too. I bet that's a play some more games there. Not if I have a change, I'll play bad very often.
Good job just to make contact. Into the windup, here comes the 0-2 pitch. The next 0-2 misses, and that'll move it to 1-2 now. Line drive to left. Solid base hit for him, his first of the afternoon.
Batting six.
Matt Duffy takes his first shot here with the runner at first now and one away.
All right, Duffy hates the ball inside.
Here it comes. Lofted in the air out toward right center. There to play it is Victorino, and that's out number two.
I'll take that over a double play. One pitch out, I would take that any day.
Batting seven.
Easy.
Second baseman, Joe Pennant.
Joe Pennant will stand in, and you see the numbers for the series so far. He's really been one of their unsung heroes.
Well, it seems like in just about every series, you get that one guy who really steps up, and he's been that guy so far.
First pitch on its way. Down and away, one ball and no strikes. And a strike to even the count. 1-1.
These fans in front, there are the towels.
Even at a ball and a strike, here's the pitch.
These are the ones who should be wearing their towels.
Two balls and a strike.
I can see the one pitching.
Scorched to third. Ah. And he tries for the backhand reach at third, but he gets by the glove down the mine.
Baez, come on.
Batting eight.
By Baez.
Left fielder.
Yeah, right. We are right.
Gets a shot now with
I should up his fielding skills too, honestly.
After
watching his performance in this series, I really should have. He's like on another level. A level above is already a good defender in this one. Final jam.
Shot fouled over towards the coaching box.
Slow it down.
And this is wide. One ball and one strike.
Good shot.
Sent on the ground out to second. There's Baez. Throw on to first, and the Giants will be turned away here as that ends the inning. Some of our nation's young minds and future leaders here in attendance.
Oh, we got Hobby at second.
Back with more from the big one. Game 7.
That's a mistake. But I'll have to fix next time we go on the field. It won't let me do it while I'm on offense. And I can't possibly change this position as an offense while I'm on offense.
First pitch of the inning is taken downstairs for a ball. It's 1-0.
These guys gotta move around. Good thing I notice. Although Hobby at second.
Hit hard to short. Crawford fields it cleanly.
So this is what I've been thinking about strategy while you're batting.
The right fielder number 20. Shane Victorino.
They've got plenty of lefties, so Hobby at second isn't bad. I'll allow
it. One gun in the inning for Shane Victorino.
I'll allow it to continue.
Bumgarner's ready. First pitch on its way. This is hit high and deep out to left.
I'll allow this to continue. Get out.
Ranging back, but he has no chance to make the play. It's off the wall. And he'll cruise into the bag at second with a one-out double.
Up next for the Cubs. Great look as we check out and show motion. Chris,
you can see him give it his all as this ball is just out of his reach. He's going to pay the price too as he crashes into that wall at full speed.
Yeah, good luck with that one, buddy.
Stepping in and ready for another shot, Chris Bryant. He flew out in his last at bat.
Flew out is generous. Flied out is grammatically correct. No, flew out is, but he usually says flied out. Damn you, Matt Vasgersian. Damn you. Let's get a little base hit.
Here's the first pitch to him. Up and in there with the first pitch fastball.
Or maybe
it's ball
he
one.
Won't give me a chance. Throw me another fastball, mad bum.
Smoke toward third. Duffy scoops it up on to first, and there were two down.
Now batting.
Left fielder, Ben Zobrist.
Joking almost. Ben Zobrist no way he was steps in throw for a second fastball up to me.
A fielder's choice his first time around.
And if he did, it was going to be certainly not a two-seamer at the belt. Ooh, sneaky bastard.
From the stretch. And he'll take strike one on the fastball, registering at 93 that time.
And he kept his head on that.
Shot
that
down the line.
We'll do it.
And that is a fair ball as this one's heading for the left field corner. And
yeah,
they're
going to
take a 1-0 lead as the run
That's
comes
a big
across
run.
The score.
That's a big run.
Nine. Second baseman, Javier Baez.
Javier Baez steps in to try and keep things going now with a runner at first following the RBI single.
And that's a nice job right there to drive in the run by the last guy. And it can definitely fire up a team when someone comes through big time with two outs.
And he takes a pitch that's ruled a strike at the knee. Pretty liberal strike zone there. It's 0-1.
Well, it's so important to be able to strike first in a postseason game. Get that first run in, especially when you're the team playing on the road. Hopefully you can take a little life out of this big crowd.
Fastball.
The 0-1. Now a fastball here, not close, and it's 1-1 now.
More specific.
And he's a little too high with that one. Two balls and a strike. A runner on first with two away. Hit high and deep out to left center field. Back goes Spann.
Out
of here. She was a wall scraper, but now just the same, a home run.
Javi showing that bum what's good.
So a two-run shot to left center. His first homer here in the series. And the Cubs have taken a 3-0 lead.
411 happy feet.
Boy, the ball is definitely jumping here early. That's the first home run we've seen so far, but it's not the first hard hit ball. And it's looking like it might
first
not throw, be such a good back night
into the play.
Up next for the Cubs.
That's a nice
Rizzo stands in there.
Rizzo.
As the first pitch to him is in there for a called strike one.
And even though that is a strike, it's okay. These guys have been really patient at the plate. They've had a good game plan up there, and it's worked out for them so far.
And this misses the outside corner, so it's knotted up at 1-1.
It's not an easy team.
Three runs already home here. And that's
that
taken
one
up
was.
And in for ball two.
And you kind of get the sense that his head isn't in it right now. You got to put all your concentration into that hitter. You can leave worrying about the past for your film session tomorrow.
Three balls.
Calling
him
out for dwelling on the pass.
To now to avoid that first walk.
And that misses for ball four.
I said I needed more walks.
And that's not the first time he's had the bat taken out of his
now
hands.
Batting.
You see right
short
there, story. A lot of pitchers just
Addison,
said, hey, with an open base,
Russell.
Forget about it. I'm going to let the next
there's
guy go.
There's towels, guys. Daddy, baby, let's go.
Here's Addison Russell. And she'll take a look at ball one.
I think that's been a big part of the problem so far. He just can't locate his fastball, especially in situations where he has to.
Also a cool. Yeah, I had to take a screenshot of that. That's pretty sweet. Oh, her ball is the slider. Loopy. Loopy throwing ball.
One pitch is a curveball just off the black. 2-1 now.
And this is a guy that needs to throw that curveball for strikes. Yeah, when he doesn't have command on it, that's when he has to lean on his fastball. And sometimes that'll get him in trouble.
And he's really given some leeway on the outside edge here. 2-2 now.
That's not a strike. It's a one down. You took
he'll show you that good breaking ball, but then he'll run that fastball up the ladder at 92, 93.
That's the same pitch.
Now a swing and a ball popped high in the air over toward foul ground. And this is going to wind up a foul ball.
Loopy curveball. No.
One, still 2-2. Making him sweat out there. The seventh pitch coming up.
Making Mad Bum sweat.
Got him swinging, and that will end the inning.
Sends me back home.
But they strike for three in the inning. Two on this two-run home run. We
Hobby
played two
strong.
And a half. It's 3-0 Chicago. Madison Bumgarner.
Leading up for the Giants.
Don't
number
get to
three.
Save your energy.
Madison Bumgarner.
Gotta treat him like a batter.
Ready with the first pitch. Here it comes. And a first pitch sinker is over for strike one.
Yeah, a tough situation here. He has the long inning on the mound, and then he's got to turn right around and lead off the next half inning.
I honestly don't know.
It's sharply toward third, and a base hit for the leadoff man is on to begin the inning.
I don't know if the catcher's signs are based on anything. I know it'll call pitches free at the lower levels. But he doesn't show a big sign, so and it's just random. And sometimes it's confusing. I like to look at it for suggestions. This dude might lay down the bunt again, so third base has got to be covering the drag bunt.
First delivery to him on the way. Cut fastball taken for strike one.
Denard. What are you thinking, man?
Chop foul over
towards
the dugout.
Not thinking bunt anymore. Whole infield has got to be double play depth for this batter. Thank you.
Reaches for one out of the zone and misses.
Not a double play, but not bad.
Well, you know when you get two strikes on you, you go into
the
that
right fielder,
mode.
Number eight, Hunter.
Let's see where this pitch lines up.
Yeah, good luck with that, Denard.
That thing's nowhere near the strike zone, and that's a good job of making
I gotta keep
working
him
off. Didn't really want to hit.
Oh, fuck this guy. Fuck you,
Here's
Hunter
the right fielder, Hunter Pence. As he
Ooh,
swings and
I
hits
let
this
that one get away from me.
To the right and out of play.
That could have been most of my lead gone.
Check swing, one but he one. Held up in time. Ball one.
If he would have swung at that, he would have never heard the end of it.
Hunter, coming for you.
Runners on first with one down.
You like a good breaking ball, don't you? Yeah,
the curveball's by him that time as he falls behind now, one and two.
Now you got to beware of that sinker. I mean, he'd take a strikeout right now, but I think he still just wants this guy to hit the ball on the ground.
Hard sinker misses, two and two.
This is where I'm not sure exactly what I want to throw, but when the catcher flashes a sign, I'll know that that's it.
Takes this the other way to right, but this will hang just long enough for him to run it down in shallow right for
and
the second
it.
Out.
Well, they've been a little unlucky so far.
For catcher, number 28,
Yeah, I signed Shane Victor, you know, because Cubs had him. On him, he was sitting
Buster
in
Posey
agency, and
is at the plate now. Flied out in his first
His numbers
bat.
Are looking also nice. His attributes, anyways. And he can play all these outfield spots. He even has
pitch
his own.
The at bat on its way.
Luke Vesker
is to the plate is a sinker for a called strike one. A runner on first with
Probably
two away.
Probably reported 6 years ago.
Can't spot the cutter any better than that. Nothing in two now.
Well, no taking now. He's going to have to swing the bat.
These fans are creeping me out, man. Breaking ball.
Squared that one out just a little late.
Switch it to the cutter.
Nothing in two count and the pitch.
Yep,
down and away, it's a ball and two strikes.
That would act more like my slider. Try my curveball, keep it down.
Got him swinging in the dirt.
Get him out, please.
Contreras finds it, but the throw is late, so the inning will continue after the strikeout pitch gets away. And not what he wanted to do there is now they'll need four outs to get out of this inning.
Yes, thank you, Matt.
Brandon Belt stands in with two on and two out here in the third.
And you know, some guys just get better with runners in scoring position and two outs. This is a big at-bat for him right here, even though it's still early.
Same thing that got me into this mess. Get me out.
Breaking ball for a strike. 0-1.
Pennant.
That is a nice pitch right there. You kind of slow it down and give him that big breaking ball to start off the at bat. Make sure he's not a guy that's going to
go anywhere I like.
That's a
sinker. One ball, one strike.
One ball, one strike.
Gets him to swing at a pitch down and out of the zone, 1-2.
Oh, he sure got a good one, doesn't he? That ball goes from about knee high to ankle high in a matter of about 5 feet.
Okay, listen.
Has to be thinking strikeout here. Off speed pitch in the dirt as he takes it for a ball.
Yeah, after that last swing, I would have thought they'd go right back in, but. That's actually not a bad location because I doubt he was looking for something.
Pick that up.
And just past his outstretched glove into left, the base hit. And they'll put the brakes on that runner at third, and that means the bases are loaded now with two away. Brandon Crawford
right now
steps into the box here in one of the bigger spots in the ballgame so far.
That was.
This is one of those make-or-break moments in a ballgame, Matt. You don't want to let an opportunity like
I want
this
that guy to be caught, but I also like Zobel. No, it's not even Zobel. Chris Bryant going out to left. Javi will take over the hot corner. It's clearly too hot for him.
He's ready. Here's the first offering.
Wow,
got fouled
that
at the plate. Strike
one. Mile.
Grounded up the first baseline. Backhanded. And he'll take it to the bag himself. And a great job of pitching out of the bases loaded situation as the side is retired. A golden opportunity to get on the board here goes for naught. Game 7 rolls on.
Extra
we're back after
and
this.
Chimes for the playoff music. Doesn't sound quite as synthesized.
Wilson Contreras is ready here as we begin
leading
the top
the
of the board.
Tiny face that
jumped out to that early
Wilson
lead, so now
Contreras.
It's all about just adding on.
Weird fans, man.
Bumgarner into his motion and delivers. And he gets ahead here with the fastball. Strike one.
That's a good pitch.
And it's quickly 0-2.
Just missed it.
That's popped up now towards short right field. Pennant is there for it, and he hauls it in for the first out of the inning.
The batter, Hendricks.
Here's that swing again. Kyle, this is in
Hendricks
show motion, and you'll see that that's a few inches above the thumbs. You'll be feeling that one all night long.
Well, my thumbs are all I can use to swing this bat, so
standing
I hope that
in
I
now,
can feel
Kyle
them.
Hendricks.
Oh yeah,
short.
Feeling them.
And that is through into center field.
I never
for a
swing first
single
pitch with a pitcher, but I like to make him work. But that is just juicy.
Give him credit. He gets the job done, and he'll take 100 of them.
Here's Dexter Fowler now. And here's a
so
ball hit in the
get
air.
Get out of play, please.
Pence on the
get
move.
Out of play, please.
He gets there and makes the play for the second out of the inning.
You're literally a chicken.
He gets you out there, but he's not missing many bats right
Victorino
now. The guys are really putting together some good swings against him so far.
So a runner at first with two away. And here's the versatile outfielder, Shane Victorino. Here comes the first pitch. First pitch back in here, and that's the first strike.
No
and for as bad
for
as he missed that pitch, you can bet we're going to see that again before this at-bat's over.
3 runs, 7 hits. No errors so far for the Cubbies.
In the dirt here. Stop right away.
Unfortunately here, no advance. And the slider's in the dirt as he lays off it for a ball.
Maybe now. He's only 25. Right now is the time.
Runners off for second. Pitch outside the throw.
Get back.
But he's safe at first as he gets back in time.
And that's another hit and run right there. But your guy is so certain he was going to throw something in his arm.
Set, here's the 3-1. Called strike two, and now it's full 3-2.
Now, 3-2, two outs.
Will be helped by the fact that that runner will get a head start out there.
Drilled on the ground is short. There is Crawford. Throw on to first, gets him, and the side is retired. Cubs strand one. But they're on top by a count of 3-0.
Shane, you're bad. What happened to your hand? It fell out, man. I got old and it fell out.
Leading off the inning,
even
Hawaii is that. They'll look to get
leading
something
off
going here and even this game
third
up.
Baseman.
In a pretty close game so
Matt
far, they'd love to
Duffy.
See this guy get on base so they can get a rally started to get back in this thing.
Hits the bottom of the strike zone here with the sinker. Strike one. Lifted in the air to straightaway center. Fowler has a read on it, and that's
Adam
the boy. First down of the inning.
I love these people hanging
the
out behind the wall in center
12.
Field that like can't
Pennant.
See anything over the wall because it's an 8-foot tall wall.
Striding into the box,
and
Joe Pennant.
Tall
he reached on a single
moves.
In his first try.
I want to take a look at that real quick because you can't see it from that camera. These guys are just chilling on this patio. Oh, not a great ball to see now. But anyways, how can they see anything? They can't. They cannot see this action. Oh, but they have towels. They do have towels.
First pitch coming.
Out.
Here it is.
Pull the string. Pull the string. Wow.
And this misses outside and a bit high. One ball, no strikes.
Let's go back to the main story, the sinker ball.
Swing and a little tapper.
That's a little better.
But it gets fouled. Tap fouled at home plate.
That's why you got shin guards.
One and
Let's
two,
block
here
this
it comes.
One, though. That's also why you got shin guards.
Two strikes.
Bases are empty, one man out. Hot shot on the ground is short. Russell has it.
Now
he knocked it down at first as it gets right by him.
That's gold glove caliber, Russell. That's hardly made any errors.
These are the kinds of plays that just have to be made. Instead, he rushes a throw and this will go as an error.
That's bullshit. It doesn't happen. No way. No way.
Gregor Blanco stands in. He's 0-for-1 after grounding out.
Well, I think it was a sinker that he rolled over last time up, and he's probably
going to
see that
be
same
a thing
pitch
that
again.
He does. You've
got to wait
for
a mistake up in the zone
in
against
game.
A guy like this.
A little bunny hop. About the bunny hop hop and do a double play. Slide
from the stretch, here's the pitch. Grounded to the right. Rizzo
yes.
is there. The second for one.
Yes.
Good hustle by
that
the pitcher there
not.
On the back end as it's a 3-6-1 double play. And the side is retired. So no runs or hits here as the error turns out to be unimportant.
Never get there in
we
time.
Played
never
four full.
In time.
It's the Cubs three. And the Giants
cover,
nothing.
That time he did, so.
Chris Bryant.
Keep it up, Kyle. Keep it up. Way to pick up Russ.
Chris Bryant.
Let's go, KB. Better pick up yourself. Let's go. That's cool.
A couple of righties starting to loosen now in the bullpen.
That's cool.
Bumgarner has his target and the pitch. Too high that time at the inning's first pitch. It's ball one. The pitch count there. One pitch into his fifth inning of work. Not much of a concern, I wouldn't imagine.
Yeah, it shouldn't be. He hasn't had any real overtaxed innings, so he should be fine for the time being.
Ball high, but not that time. See if he will.
High and away, not close. 3-0.
Looking a little off here to start the fifth.
I got a lot of contact guys behind me, and it's a foul.
And there's a strike as he'll try to work his way back. It's 3-1.
Yeah, a much better pitch there than the one he threw on 2-0.
Into his motion, here comes the 3-1. And the count will be full.
A little behind.
Ready? Now the payoff pitch. Still hanging with him. Another good swing to keep it going.
A little bit in between. Last ball and change.
Hit on the ground. Short. Crawford's got it.
Throw it away, Crawford.
And the fifth inning will start with a ground out. One away.
I guess we do that in real life.
Second baseman, number 18, Ben Zobrist.
Ben Zobrist steps in, working on a 1-for-2 game so far.
Need some agua.
Behind on that one, now behind in the count.
But if it was a slider, it would have been on the
into the windup, here comes
slide.
The 0-1. Hit to third. Duffy has it. On to first, and Bumgarner's rolling right through him here. Two away now.
How about it? Third baseman, Javier.
It's quite difficult
Javier
to deal with.
We'll dig in. 1-for-2, including a home run thus far.
Yeah, he definitely got a hold of that one earlier.
Javi figured it out, though, on the changeup.
Ready to deliver. Here's the first pitch.
Away, one ball. Is that shell shock or what? Slider.
And a good heater as he just watches this baby. A ball and a strike.
And it looks like he's rebounded pretty well. Put up a zero last time, and he's close to doing it again.
That nibbled the corner there, but missed. 2-1.
Give me a slider.
Tried a good cut there, but he can't time the breaking ball. That evens us at 2-2. In the dirt, but swung on and missed.
Wow, he ran through me with that ball this
inning. Time, and the inning is over. Nothing across here this half. Home half of the fifth coming up. Cubs
and
lead
now
it
he gets
3-0.
And he got a hit last time.
Madison Bumgarner will stand in to start things out here in the home half of the
leading
fifth.
Leading off for the Giants.
Sinker that
this crowd's been pretty well taken out of the ballgame at this point.
Bumgarner.
They've pretty much had to sit on their hands all afternoon. Not a lot to get excited about so far. And I think that's a credit to that man out there on the mound.
All
just
cut
right
cooperating.
Through this lineup for the first four innings.
Coach is not happy that he's hacking there.
And he'll fall behind now to 1-2.
He's only got 2 Ks according to that big brick wall.
Ready on 1-2. And a change up here, but that's taken low in the dirt for a ball. Fought off at the plate, and we'll do it again.
Just go away,
into the windup, here comes the 2-2 pitch. Hit out towards second. And a throw on by Zobrist gets him at first for out number one.
The center fielder, number 2, Denard Spann.
Denard look out. Span
will
look
stand
out.
In now. A punch-out victim twice already. EK, I'll ask you because you're the one sitting
definitely
next to me. Do you approach an at-bat differently when you have two strikeouts under your belt this early in the game?
Well, you do in the sense that whatever you did the first two times, it wasn't working. But I think if you start worrying too much about trying to avoid the hat trick or worse, it'll start becoming a mind game. You'll start falling into some pretty bad habits.
Off the plate, one ball, one strike. A little behind on that swing, and now he'll try to shorten up maybe and protect the plate. This is line to left. That gets down, and he's got himself a base hit. So a runner at first with one man gone. Another runner in the right fielder, Hunter Pence.
Oh, I hate you so much, Hunter Pence. Joke on a rusty nail.
First offering on its way. Pitch in the dirt, and that scoots right on by.
Unreal. Put him on.
And forget about the double play now, as he'll move up to second here on the wild pitch.
Oh, but that pitch around his ass.
Again to third. Two balls and a strike. No runs, five hits, and no errors on the giant ledger to this point. Now a look and a throw back to second, but the runner's back easily. And breaking balls bounced out towards second. Zobrist is there. Throw on to first, and Pence is turned away here for route number two.
All right, now you're looking at no way for them to manufacture a run.
Number 28,
there's a guy on
Buster
third now, but
Posey.
Two really wasn't all that helpful.
Buster Posey will stand in now. He flew out in his first time around and then was a strikeout victim last time.
No hits.
Comes set, now to pitch. Cut fastball in there for a called strike.
And against a guy like this, you're usually only going to get one pitch to hit in that bat. Sometimes you might not even get that, so that's one he may want back.
And this ball runs away for ball two. Two and one.
Yeah, and on 2-1 right now, you've got to figure this guy's wound up for the fastball here. Maybe you come with the breaking ball here out of the zone and hope he goes after it.
He's fallen behind now, 3-1. Ready on 3-1, here it comes. Hit the other way out to a right field. Victorino has a beat on it, and that retires the side.
Cut
one
just
left
enough.
For San Francisco. Still down 3-0.
Just enough. Cut.
Anthony Rizzo will get set again here as the Cubs look to get it going in their half of the sixth.
Well, you know, he's been on base twice in this one already, so let's see if he can do it again.
Other options. If we need the pinch hit here.
On the ground and right at the shifted infield. And he'll take this to the bag.
Not hard enough to complain about the shift.
Down.
And after a hot start, the bats have pretty much gone missing here in the middle inning. Sort of reinvented himself out there and has really turned things around.
Oh, he looks like he's swinging a garden hose out there as this is cut on and missed for strike one.
Yeah, he's really getting over the top of that curveball.
Just a bit late, and he's fallen behind 0-2.
He knows what I want. He's not giving it to me anymore.
Bumgarner has his sign. Here's the 0-2. lays off that time, and it's 1-2. High in the air.
Bomb.
Is there for it.
Guess I won't need a pinch hitter this inning after all, unless Wilson can do something.
There you get a look at his pitches by inning so far.
Wilson,
really, the only bad run was that third inning.
All right, let's check this out.
Wilson Contreras will step in now. He's bounced out and flown out in his first two plate appearances. Now here's the pitch. There's the first pitch curveball trying to come back to the outside corner. Didn't get it that time. It's ball one. Into his windup. Here comes the 1-0. Fly ball heading for the alley. Span giving chase.
Yeah. Get down.
He can't get there, so the inning will continue.
Go, baby.
And this will find the heart of Triples Alley out near the 421 sign. And he'll make it into third here with a two-out triple.
Oh,
he did a nice job here. Right with the pitch.
Kyle,
you can
Hendricks.
See it's on the outside part of the plate, and he just squares it up perfectly and drives it right through the empty gap.
Oh, this is where it's I wish I had Kawasaki on my roster, and I could
way to go
and
run this
nice
ball down.
Drag.
So that allows him to easily make it up to third base.
Now here
the ball? Comes Bruce Bochy out of the Giants dugout
on
his generous
way to the mound. Not even make me
and
make
he's going to make
move
a move
first.
Here, so that'll do it tonight for Madison Bumgarner.
Thanks, Bochy.
He'll depart
my
after
ball.
5-2/3 as
now
it'll
pitching
be up to
the
Giants to keep his guys in the ball.
Number 60,
Kyle Hendricks.
Hunter.
Get a shot now in an RBI spot, so a chance to help his own cause here.
And he's got a hit in the game already, so
gotta be
he can handle the bat at
Hayward.
Least a little bit.
Betting 158 in the playoffs.
Jason Hewitt will be charged
number
with the
22.
Job of getting that guy
Jason
home. He'll pinch
Hayward.
It with two gone and a runner at third.
Base hit, Jason. With a base hit. Off 52 happens to buzz 98.
Let's go.
And no swing, apparently. Ball one. Two outs here with a runner at third.
Doesn't matter now.
And oh, looked like ooh. Ball two below the knees, but it's ruled a strike, and that evens the count at 1-1.
Yeah.
And that's through into right field for a base hit. And to score is the runner from
third. That's what I'm talking about.
And makes it a 4-0 ball game.
Nice job right there. Hitting with the runner in scoring position. He just gets out in front and yanks his ball right through the hole.
Yeah, fucking
that'll score that runner easily from third base.
Now some action out in the Giants bullpen as they'll have both the left-hander and the right-hander get loose. Here's Dexter Fowler now. Pitch out, nothing doing. Two out with the man at first. Fastball down the field, it's 1-1. Very difficult to get on top of a pitch when it's coming in that high.
Darn near impossible when it's coming at you in the high 90s. You just can't get your hands up there fast enough to stay on top.
Throw over to the bag, and the runner back safely.
Got a pretty good lead right there.
I'll take the lead off.
High high fly ball out to straightaway center. Span has it in his tracks. He makes the play, and that'll end the inning. Two hits in the inning lead to a run for Chicago. To the bottom of the sixth we go. Four,
oh, that's
five,
a big run.
Coming up. It's the
still in slam range.
And the Giants
still in slam range. Gotta lock it up. Lock it up, Travis Wood.
Travis Wood will come on now as he'll start out the bottom of the
gotta
six.
Go through my warm-ups because it helps my pitch confidence. And I need every little tiny advantage I can get to make sure that this isn't the end of my season. So let's just make sure all these pitches are landing in the strike zone. Slide piece. It's a little bit wide. Gotta throw it again. Because that one will be useful. Let's bury that again. Don't need the change up so much. Let's bring in the two-seamer. And make sure we feel good about our cut fastball. Wood's missing his country entrance music
back
right
alongside
now.
Alongside Eric Harris and Steve Lyons.
Leading
Matt
up for the Giants.
As it'll be Brandon Belt getting ready to lead things Brandon. Off here for San Francisco.
That would have been really cool if they just did a continuous shot into the broadcast camera, but that would have been way too advanced for them. Just in case things get dicey when I'm going, we'll see what he's got. Oh, his overall's gone down because he's not pitching well. That's not going to help him pitch better.
Nope. There's a fastball missing down and away for a ball, 1-0.
Well, you know, if there's anybody in this lineup capable of getting a rally started, this is the guy right here.
I agree, Will. Let's go with the cutter.
Went about halfway there, but it's a called strike regardless.
That worked out pretty well. Where to next? He doesn't have a ton of heat. But he's got enough.
Called strike in a dangerous location there, 1-2.
One of that in, but he wasn't ready for that, Maple. Slide piece.
Here's the 1-2 delivery. That misses, and we're even at 2-2.
Too soon. Yeah, not a ton of gas, but he's got some. Oh.
A little late with the swing, but he stays alive. Still 2-2.
Still not working out. I'm going to make sure this one is buried in on his hand. Well, that would work if I was throwing a cutter as a righty.
And now he'll step off as they look for a strikeout pitch. Swing and a fly ball. Bryant sprinting after it, and this will fall, but it's a foul ball.
No way. Or somewhere. Happens.
He's ready with the 2-2 pitch. Chop foul at the plate.
Go away.
Do it again.
Stop it. If you really want me to throw this cutter again, I'll throw it. Yeah, the fan dares me to do it. I don't like that. I don't like that. Little San Francisco kid wants me to throw the cutter. I'm going slider again.
Locked in a good battle. Here comes another one. And the slider misses here, so he runs the count full 3-2. One thing that man right there will not tolerate, leadoff walks.
No shit.
Especially right out of the bullpen. This might be a quick outing if that happens.
It's going to be a quick outing regardless. Now you want me to throw a slider? I don't think so. Too soon.
And that one misses, so the leadoff man will head down to first on ball four to start the bottom of the sixth.
Yeah, nothing on the scoreboard yet, so maybe this can be a start as he's on base to lead off.
other Brandon.
Brandon Crawford Brandon will dig in here. One
it's
for
actually
two.
Worse against the Reggie, so it's time so to go to Clippers.
Yeah, putting the ball
your attention,
away.
Please.
Sometimes that's half
now
the
pitching for the
Tyler
Chicago
Clippers
Cubs.
Take over
number
19.
Specialist.
Clipper.
There's double plays. Plus, I love his motion. It's quick. It's fluid. Let's get another one of those great repertoires. Not when I throw a splitter like that, though. Eep. Yeah. Change. Yep. Splitter. I said splitter. Oh, yeah.
Brandon Crawford will be the first to stand in against the new pitcher as he'll do so with a runner
Brandon
at first and nobody out.
Crawford.
He's set and the pitch. And who? Looks like he got the call there on the pitch inside. It's nothing and one.
All right. Leadoff man on first. Here's where you got to start clawing your way back into this ballgame. It's not too late, but it needs to start happening soon.
Grounded foul toward the third base dugout.
Oh, that's the end I should swing with. Oh, okay.
Inside, as that perhaps will back him off a bit. One and two.
How do you take that? You know you're going to hit the play, that's all. Alright, let's just heat him up. Oh.
Still one and two as he fouls it away.
Fighting. They do not want to lose this game fucking seven. But I will not let them have it.
Just inside,
oh,
not by much. It's two and two.
You can see where they want to go to try and get him out. A lot of pitches in on the hands in this sequence. They don't want him to be able to extend.
He's set. Here's the 2-2. And this is swung on and missed as Crawford is set down on strikes, one away.
Oh, that's a sweet pitch right there. You know, on the mound, there's
third
very
baseman,
few things
number
that can
five,
happen negatively with this location.
Madison,
I mean,
Duffy.
You're either going to swing and miss, you foul it off, or you hit it into the ground where it becomes a double play. But I'm sure on the mound, you'll take the strikeout.
I'll take the strikeout. Now I'll take a double play. Oh, Duffy can't stand the ball in, though.
Into the box now,
it.
Matt Duffy, as he takes a fastball.
But I got to get some calls.
Ball 1-0.
Shoot.
Runner at first here, one
this.
Man out.
He doesn't call this corner. He doesn't call this corner. Get dirty.
Now a throw over to third. Back in standing.
A simple throw over there.
Now a chopper to first. Might only really get one. Reined in. And they'll get the fielder.
Oh, be okay. Be okay. He's okay.
But this is a much easier
a second baseman, number 12,
to make, especially when you're charging in like that. He doesn't have to turn his back to the plate, so he gets a good gauge on whether he still has time or not, and he's able to fire on
side asshole
in time to get that force out.
Nice throw. Also, not throwing your way. Two down.
Here's Joe Panic. As the first pitch to him is off the plate for a ball, 1-0. A runner on first with two away.
That's hat. What the fuck?
Swing and a ball chop foul right at home plate. Runner goes for second. Pitches a cold strike. The throw. Not in time as he steals second.
That don't prepare me. So long as I get my money in this batter. Just need to get the batter out.
Instead, you see it's wide of the mark.
off to the shortstop side of the base, and he's able to beat that tag to get in safely.
Runner in scoring position at second with two down.
You can't hit my changeup.
Shot foul at the plate. It'll remain one and two.
Can't hit it.
Ready to deliver the one and two. And a splitter here, but he had a bit too much on it as this bounces up to the plate.
When a pitcher's close to getting through a quick inning, this is where you really need to grind out your at-bats, especially as a bottom-of-the-order guy. So this is a good job, sir.
And this misses, so that'll fill the count at three and two.
Now, he does have first base open, so he doesn't have to come in right here. He can try to make that perfect pitch, and you know what? If he misses, who cares?
And that misses ball four, so it's first and second now with two out.
You can't fall
left fielder
like
number
four the location. It's well played. Maybe just a hair off the outside.
The question is
3-2, that's where you want
to
be.
Step in now as his guys look for a breakthrough here with a runner in scoring position.
Let's talk to him. See if I can get his confidence up.
Anything with their opportunities so far.
Otherwise, it's not
going to happen. They finally crack the scoreboard.
Now time is called here as we'll get a trip to the mound.
I'll give you a shot. Let's go.
From the stretch. And he throws the fastball by him here. 0-1. One of the things that makes him so tough to hit, the ability to put his pitches right on the black.
Very good start.
You watch the catcher's glove on some of these, and it literally does not move. That's how good his stuff is.
And a classic 0-2 pitch as the changeup misses low, and it's 1-2 now. Where are you going here?
I'm throwing that same pitch again. Make him prove that his plate discipline is such that he can lay off it twice in a row.
Not the craziest idea I've ever heard, but first I gotta come in with this game.
Looking forward to strikeout. Here's the 1-2.
There's
a fastball in on the fist, and that'll even things up at 2-2.
And the hope was that he would have chased one of those pitches, but now on 2-2, I don't think you fool around anymore.
Chopped foul right at home plate.
Dude, just go down quietly. Come on. Be a good boy.
Ana trying to take control of the inside part of the plate with the fastball as he backs him off a bit.
Oh, they
nothing's really come easy for him so far on the mound. He's had to work for everything, and now he's got to deal with another full count.
Good battle here. This will be the seventh pitch coming up. Fights off another pitch and hits a foul right at the plate.
No, I'm not throwing it. I'm probably an idiot.
Full count. Here it comes.
And now there's a ball. That's why I didn't want
to throw it. This goes straight to the backstop.
Well, we knew
the pitcher, number 16,
scoring position.
Hunter,
correct line. While they're letting the relief pitcher back. That doesn't mean
your attention, please. We'll get the call here as he'll hit for the pitcher.
Number 16.
Game in the balance right here.
Now pitching for the Chicago.
Gotta use my guys.
Number 56.
This might hit those numbers. He's still my guy. He's still Hector. Let's go.
And it looks like the Cubs will get a left-hander up and working out of the bullpen.
I gotta show him the slider.
Angel Pagan is in with two away as he takes a ball 1-0.
This crowd's been something else here in this series. They are really making it tough on him.
1-0 delivery. And he fires in a strike this time to make it one ball and one strike.
That thing's coming in there hot. 96 miles an hour.
Two seamer? Four seamer.
Up high. 2-1 now.
And that fastball, his definitely catches your attention, especially when it's on the inner half.
Two seamer. Belt. That could have tied the game. That. Oh, wow. Okay. Reset.
Hard hit ball to second. Zobrist has it, and an underhanded throw is in time for out number three.
And we escape yet again.
Giants leave them loaded. They trail here 4-0.
Two-thirds of the way there.
Back here in San Francisco. On to the seventh inning now in Game 7. But before we start, we take a look at our game
great
summary
highlight
at this point.
For San Fran there. Matt Duffy.
Your Derek attention,
Law,
please.
Is on the now pitching to the Giants.
Actually,
starting
cool.
Number
64. I saw his tweet or his story or whatever about how he enjoyed us hating him, and now I don't hate him anymore, so ha. Huh.
Stepping in, Shane Victorino.
Leading out for the Cubs
hitter will take his cuts
left-handed
here.
And you know, guys, he's not quite as successful when he's batting left-handed in general. He tends to have more success from the other side.
Maybe not a bad time for Chap to throw a few. And then nobody else has energy. Warren. I've been starting for me, but it's Game 7, baby. Adam Warren is my Madison Bumgarner. Let's go.
Up and away to start the inning. It's 1-0. And he'll just get a piece here as this is chopped foul at home plate.
Oh, he likes that changeup.
All 2-1. Pretty clear the plan is to keep everything away.
And that's smart for most guys, but you got to know your status.
I just got this terrible feeling in the pit of my stomach that, like, these Giants will want revenge for the comeback that the Cubs had on the real Giants in the NLDS. But I'm not going to give them that satisfaction.
And a good
but if he throws me more of these circle changes,
back to even at 2-2.
Yeah, not a real good effort there. That pitch was never going to be a strike.
Okay. Focus. How do I focus when this dude is, like, trying to call his Falcon back to him?
Liner towards second, but an atom ball right to him for the first down.
Oh, I timed up the changeup.
He's got two hits already.
Left fielder
probably should have been his third.
Right.
But he hits it right to his man, and that's going to keep him off base.
Damn.
Chris Bryant will stand in now. He's been kept quiet out of the number three hole, hitless in his three at-bats so far.
Yeah, I mean, he's definitely one of the better hitters in this
Let's
lineup.
KB.
That's why he's in the middle of the order. He just hasn't been able to get it going today. It happens.
Good timing. Squared it up. Line drive. But right at him. Next.
Here it comes.
Trying to jam him with the first pitch slider, but it's in a bit too tight for ball one. Now he lifts a high pop up.
KB can't
foul territory on the right side. Belt able to pull this one in for route number two.
The second baseman, number 18.
Well, Ben, one thing you can say, he's showing a lot of composure coming right at these guys. And for a young pitcher, that can be uncommon.
Why is that but,
you know, he
so
puts
dark?
This pitch in a good spot, gets this guy to pop it up.
Here's Ben Zobrist now.
There it is. And I still popped
it
up.
Ball out to right center. Coming in a span.
Change up.
And that ends the inning.
Easy.
Three up, three down for the Cubs.
It's time for the traditional seventh-inning stretch.
Top of the order, eh?
Denard Span will stand in to start things off as this top of the batting order hasn't found a whole lot of success so far.
Denard Span!
Back just one hit between the 1-2-3 hitters combined. So apparently the table setters have not been getting their chores done.
Now a fastball on the inside corner, and
nice
he takes a look at strike one.
In the 60-degree weather,
trying to be a little bit more patient here. He's got two strikeouts already, but he's got to be careful not to fall too far
Giants
behind.
Check it. Giants, check it.
Rondon's ready. Here it is on 0-1.
I got it.
Up. Rizzo is there for it. Looks it into his glove, and there's one gone.
The right
it's
fielder,
telling of
number
how
eight,
they've swung the
Hunter
bat. This has
Pennant.
Just been a punchless offense so far. And this pop-up is pretty indicative of their struggles.
Hunter Pence will step in. A ground out victim his last time.
Fuck you, Hunter. You can suck my dick.
In there, strike one. A swing and a miss that time by Pence as he falls behind here, nothing in two.
Fuck you, Hunter. You can suck my dick.
Not a bad pitch there with two strikes, but it misses one and two.
He showed him that slider running away two times in a row. Now might be a good time to call him that two-seamer running in.
No way I could throw another one, is there?
The 1-2 pitch. Protecting with two strikes. Went out of the zone that time, but he stays alive. Lake making contact on that swing and will do it again on 1-2.
Get up.
Fastball. Well, look out. That just about got him in the coconut. Can't imagine guys like that too much.
Yeah, not too much indeed. You start getting into the danger area when it's up and in that eye.
Almost.
And here's a ball hit in the air. Contreras waits on it. Two gone.
To work, big fella.
Whatever he's doing out there, it's working out.
Number 28.
Back-to-back pop-ups here to start the inning. He's just making it look easy.
Buster Posey stands into the box. He could really use a knock here. 0-3 in the game so far.
Now let's be listening here, shall we? Starting out with the sliders again. Yeah.
Swung on and missed. It's 0-1. Credit where credit's due. This guy's done a good job out of the bullpen.
No question. He's been able to hold that lead, and these guys really haven't threatened him at all.
High in the air out to center field. Fowler moving to his left. No trouble with this one, and the inning is over. Giants are down 1-2-3. They're down 4-0.
Let's get some offense. Let's get some runs. Let's get some insurance. Let's go. couldn't see the pass. I'll be able to keep here. Oh, I've been tossing Chicago to lead off the inning. Since Laurie. Oh, you hit that nice bomb you just showed me.
Comes set. Here's the nothing and nothing pitch.
Oh,
on one swing and missed that time. It's 0-1.
Is it too late to go to Chicago?
And that's exactly how you have to attack the guy. He wasn't even close on that pitch.
Not the greatest at bat thus far as he misses that pitch in the dirt and falls behind nothing and two now.
Yeah, he was out front right there, probably guessing fastball. But now, 0-2, you can't be guessing anymore. You got to find something in the strike zone.
And a check swing here, but the bat clearly breaks the plane as he set down for
first
the first
base
out.
Number
time to give you a look now at the numbers for our two starting pitchers, and really nothing to write home about on either line as neither guy was able to last even six innings.
Ready and waiting. Ready and waiting.
Pitch on the way. Anthony Rizzo is in now as he watches a pitch for ball one.
I think he was trying to get that slider in on his hands, but I don't think he meant for it to get in that far. I think he just released it a little too late.
And he won't bite at that one either. It's 2-0.
A guy like this with kid gloves, walk him if you have to, but don't let him be the one to beat you.
Late swing on the hitter's count. Still a good count for him now, however, at 2-1. The 2-1 on its way. Chops it foul at home plate as the count moves to 2-2 now. Even at 2-2, here it is. Lifted the other way out to left center. Calling for it, Blanco. And that's the second out of the inning.
Now batting, shortstop, Addison Russell.
Addison Russell stands in. He got under one and popped out his last time up. Now the pitch. Up and in there with the first pitch.
That's
fastball. It's ball one.
Ball.
Got him to swing at a pitch below the knees. 1-1. Really a good job so far by this guy out of the bullpen.
Yeah, he's come in and really put his stamp on this game. Throwing a lot of strikes.
Perplexed.
Can't keep the weight back, and he falls behind 1-2. Fly ball out toward right field. Hence, under it, and he makes the catch for out number three. Cubs are down in order, but they're in front 4-0. Brandon Belt. Stand in now to lead things off,
16,
and he'll do so with the same pitcher still out
Giants.
There. Seems he's earned himself
first
another inning.
That's a definite vote of confidence, but he's done a nice job since coming in, so you might as well ride that hot in.
Bat explodes as this has popped up. Baez near the bag at third, one down.
He's ready to
this
the
isn't always the way you want to play it here. It's late in the game, your guys are losing. Wouldn't be such a bad idea to take a pitch or two. Instead, he chases after the very first pitch, and it's an easy out.
Brandon Crawford, ready to take another shot, went down on strikes his last time up.
Yep, they sent him packing last time, so maybe they have a pretty good idea of how to attack him again right here.
And that's in there for strike one.
One's the count.
One out, nobody on.
0-2 now. 0-2. As Crawford comes up empty on that one.
Yeah, a couple of mid-90s fastballs, and he hasn't been close on either one of them.
Oh, and he dusted him off the plate that time. Some mind games being played now. It's 1-2.
Mind games.
That's what you call getting in tight with fastball.
Very weakly on the ground, but that one rolls foul. Bases are empty, one man out.
That's good.
Just trying to freeze him with the fastball there. Pretty close. It's 2-2. Grounder hit hard.
Oh, you gotta put that, Riz.
Backhanded reach at first, but he can't flag it down.
Gotta put that, Riz. Yeah, they're gonna give you an error. Yeah, you gotta put that.
He might have been unsure which way to turn his glove, over or under the ball. Instead, just goes right through him.
Matt Duffy will stand in now in what could be a real make or break situation.
Okay, I think Rondon will get one more batter.
The further you get into that bullpen, the tougher it's going to be to claw back from this deficit.
Hit in the air to straightaway center. Fowler has a lead on it. He's got it, and there are two down there.
Starting to catch on, but I'm looking outside. But that was probably, hopefully, his last at bat of the season. So it's a little bit too late. Too little, too late.
Joe Pennant stands in, reached on a walk in his last trip.
Lineup wise, ooh, double switch. I'm gonna take out. Ooh, who do I even want to take out? I like all these guys a lot. That's Monty, I'll do. Better slot is gonna. Ooh, I could do.
There's Joe Maddon up out of the dugout now on his way to home plate, so it looks as though he's going to call for the double switch here.
Excuse me. But here comes Mr. Chapman.
Number 54.
See what he's got in the tank.
Chapman. Now playing right field and batting in the ninth spot. Number 25. Yasmani Tomas.
Yep, fastball is great. Slider is very fast also. Change up, still pretty fast, but this fastball, throwing BBs, good luck boys, throwing BBs.
Joe Pennant steps in, working on
the
a one for two game
number
so
12,
far.
Joe Pennant.
Chapman sets. Here comes the first pitch. And he lays off a pitch in there for the first
time. Iron darts.
I think he had to
shooting
take
lasers.
That one. I'm not even sure he saw it.
Good hard slider there, but it runs away. It's a ball and a strike. Ready to deal. Here's the 1-1.
No time to decide.
1-0-2. To 2-2 now.
88 on the slide,
so tough on left-handed hitters. That slider is just so difficult to pick up.
Gotta go Peter. Firing darts. Oh,
full count, three balls and two strikes. Two out with a man at first. Skied in the air to straightaway left. Bryant moves.
That'll work.
And that's the third out. Giants lead one. They're on the short end of a 4-0.
See if we get a little more insurance. A little more insurance. That'd be cool.
Bay Bridge, and at the other end, the city by the bay as we continue.
Oh, the moon going down in there in that shot. I just noticed for the first time. That was sweet. Some of those shots are really cool. Some are trashy. The St. Louis ones are trashy, which I love. There's a magical changeup that all of a sudden turned into a slider there.
And he misses with it one.
That was
one.
A slider. That's what
you have to do against a big sweeping slider like that. It starts in the zone and it's probably going to finish out of the zone, so that's a good job just to lay off.
Hit in the air out to left field.
That one just got jacked way up in the air.
And the leadoff man retired here to kick off the ninth.
The batter, right fielder,
number 25, Yasmani Tomas. Double switched in a moment ago.
Digging in, Yasmani Tomas, as he'll get his first opportunity in this one.
Hit a home run off that little gray angled thing on the top of the brick wall there at the top, cement, which is exactly where I think it was Hunter kind of hit one in the actual NLDS, and it was correctly ruled not a home run, but here in this game they would get a home run in game 6, which I ended up losing 3 days, obviously. In 15 innings or less. They called it a home run off of there. Couldn't reverse it. Couldn't do anything about it except accept my run.
And here's a pitch inside. Ooh. And they got him.
Yeah, he also got hit by a few balls in the regular season. That leg kick helps.
Here's Dexter Fowler now. Hit hard toward the right side.
Oh, this is speared. Wow. That could have, should have been two bases and outs. But it's neither.
This probably should have been much more than that, but they can't wind up making the play.
Dude, could miss that. Do I want to bring it up pinch hitter for all this at this point? No. Fire and darts. Firing darts. Well, that one I should have probably washed the ball out of the pitcher's hand, even while trying to bunt. It's like I took on the form of Aroldis and he doesn't know what to do with a bat. No more bunting.
He waits, now the pitch. Grounder down the line at first. But a foul ball, and the count holds it on two.
This is the only one who was close to hitting that changeup for a... Well, I had the one-liner.
Looking to put him away, here's the 0-2.
One ball, two high. Two strikes.
One and two. A runner on first with two away.
Was that Zobrist? This team is based almost my whole lineup. Basically my whole lineup.
Off the
I just want to know the gas, man.
That's pretty good patience out there for a pitcher who's acting like a hitter, especially with two outs.
Here's the pitch on 2-2. Swing and a miss. Blew the fastball right.
All right, dude, just
the inning is over. So no runs here, no hits, no errors, and one man left on. We'll see 8-9-1 do up in the bottom of inning number 9. It's the Cubs 4 and the Giants nothing. Gregor Blanco
will come forward now, trying to stave off elimination.
Leading off for the Giants here at the bottom of the ninth.
Their half of the ninth.
Left fielder, so hard number seven.
Everything they've worked for all season long comes down now to these final three outs.
No ninth inning comebacks for you guys. Yeah, let him know I have the changeup. It's not a bad call, Will.
Starts him out with a changeup off
the plate
for ball one.
Think about it.
Two and oh.
Shoot. All right, two strikes.
Drops one down here, and he'll try to beat it out.
Do it.
But the throw will beat him at first, so the bunt for a hit attempt is snuffed out.
Pitcher number 64.
See what he's trying to do right here.
Derek's
been such a
strong
these guys to score runs so far. He's thinking about taking a little bit of a different approach up there. He had the right idea, it just didn't really work out for him.
Your attention, please.
We'll grab a bat and hit for the pitcher.
Kelby.
Number 38, Kelby Tomlinson.
A guy named Kelby. A guy named Gorkus. Gorkus.
In there, and it's 0-1.
Now he might have been on the on-deck circle just saying, man, I get one
I
at
want
bat
it bad,
and
it's against
this
guy.
Thanks a lot.
One out, nobody on. Starts to go around here, but it doesn't matter.
Fire.
This is strike two anyway. Mm-hmm. Boy, no messing around here in this ninth inning.
And that's a closer's mentality. They're not usually the best at setting guys up. They're going to come right at you with their best pitch, and that's usually a fastball.
A little late on the fastball, but he's able to spoil that one off, and he'll get another chance. And that is swung on and missed, and things are starting to look bleak here for the home nine. There are two away now.
And that changeup's not really a pitch you can sit on with two strikes. Because if he gives you that fastball, you'll be an hour late on it. That's a great job of not showing that pitch until he was ready to punch him out.
Denard Span will stand in, and their season hangs in the balance here as they're down to their final out.
This dude will definitely try and lay down a bunt if I don't bring up Bryant. Hobby on him.
Swing and a ground ball. This could do it. And joy in Wrigleyville tonight. Say it with me, folks. Holy cow, the Cubs are going to the World Series.
Oh, wow, that's awesome. Yeah. Let's do it, boys. Let's win it all.
Boy, that's one happy bunch of guys down there right now. They are the National League champions, but they know they're not done yet. They've got one more big hurdle standing in front of them. But these guys are looking like they're going to be awfully tough to beat.
Well, you always hope to get a good outing.
Player of the game, five innings pitched. But yeah, he did put us right in there in position to win.
Yeah, I thought he really pitched well.
I got no gripes with that, although Javi was looking pretty good.
Aside from that, he was definitely a difference maker out there.
Wow, that's all they're going to do for me winning the NLCS. The rest is textbook. Oh, that camera's dark because it's behind the dark glass, and it's fuzzy, too. Yeah, what's up with that? Oh, there we go. Sweet.
For Eric Carroll, Steve Lyons, and our entire crew, I'm Matt Vaskirjan. This has been the NL Championship Series on MLB The Show.
Just casual bro hugs everywhere. Slow-mo bro hugs, baby. That's how you celebrate. Yeah, Rossi and Lester just got intimate. It's perfect.
Here now is the final night score tonight. First for the victorious Chicago Cubs. Four runs on nine hits. Two errors. They left seven men on base.
Let's see how we got here.
For the Giants, no runs, five hits, no errors. They left 11.
Oh, yeah.
Time of the ball game, 2 hours and 39 minutes.
Brisk. Briskly played game. 239.
41,503. The Giants thank you for attending tonight's game at AT&T Park.
Big pinch hit.
Please buckle up and drive home safely. Good night.
Oh, nothing about see you next year. Well, guess what, Giants? We'll see you next year. I would like to say that. Alright. I saw a couple people pop in and out. If anybody actually watches this, then that's pretty cool. And I'm glad you got to experience my joyous occasion of getting the NL Pennant for the Cubbies, baby. Got myself one more series to play. Oh, that's pretty sweet. Well, it's been oh so real, people. But, I think that just about wraps her up. Oh, I'll exit the game. Am I ready? I want to soak this in a little bit. Screenshot. Yeah. It's looking good. Alright, I'm ready. Freudian slip. Alright, guys. Thanks for joining. This is the big spliff. Oh, there's one more shot. One more shot you ought to see. The Cubs have won the National League Championship Series. And we'll be taking on the Mariners in the World Series. Autosave. Wabam. Fuck you, Bumgarner. Fuck you, Hunter Pence. And wow, I got 3 days off. Sweet, I get my pitching staff back. And I don't get home field because the All-Star game. Oh, baby. Let's hear it. There's no radio. The radio guy just disappears. He doesn't say, oh, the Cubs went to the World Series. The guy on the radio stopped saying people's names. He went like, the Cubs pitcher number 49 got the win. In a great effort. Like, really? That's Jake fucking Arrieta. Who, by the way, is not allowed to run in this playoffs because he's just a stud. 24 innings, 5 walks. I mean, you see the numbers. Half a base runner per inning. Including, game 1 no hitter. He's put up 1 full war exactly in 24 innings pitched in 3 games. If that's not badass, then I don't know what is. Alright, I'm just rambling now. I'm pumped. I'm tired. It's a hard-fought series. I'm definitely not throwing Adam Warren first. It'll be fun. Let's just see what my stamina levels. Yep, everyone's good to go. Johnny Lester needs one more day. Gonna do a little bit of Safeco. Should be fun. Peace out.